Okay, Monday night break here. Player break. This is one full case of Diamond Kings. 12. I guess it's an inner case, a full inner case. 12 box case of Panini Diamond Kings. We may do a second one of these also. I have a couple more cases available, so I haven't opened any myself. I might at some point, but I haven't opened any, so this is the first I've seen it. I'm sure some of you guys have seen it before. We're going to do a Gypsy Queen player break, I think, next week. So, as often with these eBay player breaks, I'm not going to read everybody's players because that'll bore you guys for 20 minutes. You guys know you have, they're in your eBay folder. Everybody was sold. I sold all the unsold people to one person, and then several people are in the field lot also. So, we're all ready to go. I will do a recap of this, and I will also post to YouTube like always. I did drop the link earlier there. That's our Facebook group. We have almost 500 members in that. I do a lot of my team breaks on Facebook. It's just a little bit more economical without having to pay eBay fees. And they usually fill pretty quick. So if you're interested in doing some team breaks with us, you don't even have to really have a Facebook account. I got several people on there that just log in under a dummy name to try to get in breaks. But you're welcome to join. Need a box cutter. Good luck, everybody. Had some good cards pulled last night. Let's see if we can do it again. Rules are for multiple player cards. I'm not sure how many are in Diamond Kings, but it's very simple. If it's a dual, triple, quad card, whatever, each player has action, no majority rule. So if you got one of four players, you'll have one of the four chances on a randomizer. If it's a real expensive card and the owners want to come to some agreement, buy it out from each other before the random, they could do that. It's always fun to hit something that's that expensive that you have to worry about it. I did this in a player break last year and I had a fantastic case. Or it was a team break. I can't remember. I remember having a really good Diamonds Kings case last year. It's doing pretty well in the wholesale market, so it must be a decent looking product. Because if it's not, it's usually punished in the full case market. So let's start it off. I know they have a lot of nice relic cards in this stuff. Our next break, we might do a few boxes afterwards tonight, but our next regular break will be Museum Baseball on Wednesday night. I will post teams on Facebook on Tuesday night. Pick your team. We'll go through the box all at the same time like normal. Every card is sent out on pretty much all of our breaks, so you get your base if you're wondering. Just started, Slugger. What do you got, Kevin? Or can I guess? Well, I know you don't have James McCann if you were asking about him. You usually go after K-Line, but I don't know if he had his own spot or not. I think he probably did. God, the cards look nice. Miggy, JD, and Cobb. Well, Cobb's a fun spot because they put a lot of Cobb stuff in this. I hit a Ty Cobb out of this product 1 year. I don't know if it was last or the last year or the previous, but I hit a Ty Cobb once out of this. All right, they're colorful looking cards. They definitely have the Diamond King look. I like them. It kind of fits with the Panini having to do the no logos. The painting kind of fits with that whole strategy. Aficionado insert, Carlos Correa. Nope, still got him, Steve. I signed off after we were done. Got a mini card of Mikel Franco. A heritage insert of Frank Robinson in the Cincinnati uniform. No, you ended the night last night with that crazy good hit. We got a turned around card. I'm not sure if that means autograph or not. It does not. I don't know. Why was it turned around? Is it a variation? Well, it's a Schwarber. And it was turned around. Oh, yeah, it is a variation. Because I hit his base card already, too. Yep. Short print photo variation. Nice hit there for Schwarber. Too bad about him. Hopefully he comes racing back next year. Tough card though, I'm sure of him. Expressionist Ricky Henderson. They got Shoeless Joe Jackson relics in this. That's kind of neat. Well, the relic card is James McCann. We were just talking about him. With a bat and a jersey. Let me guess, Kevin, you came in second place on him. James McCann, dual relic. I can guess your predicament instantly. It's like I'm torturing you. Framed card of Caleb Cowart. Oh, really? Who's the backup there now? Ken Griffey Jr. Originals insert. It's not Avila anymore, right? He went somewhere else. Memorable feats, Elston Howard. Oh, okay. The guy's last name I cannot pronounce. We call him Salty. He went to White Sox. Didn't Avila, isn't his dad in the Tiger organization? That must have been kind of uncomfortable. We got a artist proof parallel of Johnny Sane. That is number 95 of 99. We'll go in the recap. Aficionado insert of Paul Goldschmidt. Corey Seager rookie. Mini card of Rusney Castillo. Heritage insert Robin Yount. Well, I know this isn't an autograph card. That's probably a photo variation, I would guess. It was turned around. Short print, Roberto Clemente. Nice looking painting. Roberto goes up about every year. I would say in the last 10 years, he's had the best run of any vintage player for value increase. Expressionist Justin Upton. Okay, it'll be on YouTube tonight. Right after the break, I will start uploading. The YouTube link is on the emails I send out. All right, 27 of 99 autograph for the LA Angels. Two-piece jersey of Caleb Cowart. It's signed, I think, with a Bible verse there, even though it's a little sketchy, but I'm pretty sure that's what that is. Studio Portraits. Finish up box number one. Bill Dickey parallel number to 99. Originals Chris Bryant insert. Nice looking card there. It's a nice looking Pee Wee Reese card. Memorable feats, Nap LaJoy. And a Trey Turner rookie is the last card. One box down. We'll go a little quicker through as we go. I'm just looking at this stuff for the first time. Making sure I know what to pull for the recap. Oh, Vila's White Sox, huh? My two catchers for fantasy baseball this year is Steven Vogt, and I got the Rockies catcher, Hundley. In a 16-team, two catcher league, so catchers get very deep. Well, you know what? The first card is the same as that Clemente. Oh no, they're different. They're different. Very similar, but not the same. Box number two, good luck. Got a Clemente base, Honus Wagner, Chris Bryant. Number to 99, artist proof Adrian Beltre. Aficionado insert Josh Donaldson. Mini of Lefty O'Doul. Heritage Mike Schmidt. It's a Ty Cobb card turned around. I don't think it's an autograph. Looks like a variation. Variation of Ty Cobb. Expressionist David Ortiz. Is a card numbered out of... I'm not sure. Let me turn it around. This might be a hit card. Looks like a sketches and swatches. Oh, it's an autograph too. Nice card there for the Steven Piscotty lot. For the St. Louis Cardinals, sketches and swatches. It is a sticker auto. And it's numbered 9 of 99 for Piscotty. Ruzney Castillo framed. Originals insert of Clayton Kershaw. Memorable feats Mel Ott. Corey Seager rookie. There's Bottomley there. Aficionado Dallas Keuchel. Andy Pettit, Mini. Heritage insert of Lou Brock there. Second half of box two. Always a good player to have turned around. Mike Trout, photo variation. Ozzie Smith, Expressionists. This is probably the relic. Number 4 of 49. Two-piece relic of Yasmani Tomas for the Arizona Diamondbacks. Another parallel of Caleb Cowart. Number 24 of 99. Originals, Giancarlo Stanton. Schwarber and Trey Turner rookies there. Insert card of Walter O'Malley. Not a favorite in Brooklyn. And two boxes down. Box number 3. Steve, what are you going to do with the Benintendi? Do you want me to list it for you? I can do that if you want me to. I know Jason was looking it over today. Yeah, I think it's got a chance at a 9.5, but probably not. I would say like a 25% chance, like a 1 in 4 or 1 in 3. You know, you get the right grader, you can always get a 9.5, unless it's got something serious, which it doesn't, but its centering overall is pretty weak. And that corner definitely is showing a little white. Centering might be a bigger issue than even the corner, but like I said, it could still 9.5 if you want to gamble. It really wouldn't be that big of a gamble. But you also get the money quicker when you just sell it. If I list on eBay, what date was that 9/10, Steve? What date? Box 3. Joe Mauer Mini. Adam Wainwright Aficionado. What's going on, Jacob? Steve, I told Jacob about your big hit. He was jealous. He knows I always hit him those type of cards though in loose boxes. Another Schwarber. Second Schwarber photo variation. I had a tough Kyle autograph last night too. Since he got hurt, I can't stop hitting him. Orlando Cepeda insert. We got something different here. You guys see that? Behind the James McCann. Hope this is interesting. It's number 19 of 49. Oh, it's just a framed mini, isn't it? Framed mini. One piece jersey. That's Billy Martin, though. Man, I can't tell you the last time I had a Billy Martin stuff. He probably doesn't have that much. It's a nice looking card. Billy Martin. And that is number 19 of 49. Manager, New York Yankees. I would bet you anything that there's some eBay love for this type of card. Keep going here. I do. March 2nd. That's over a month ago. I think he may have gone up since then, Steve, to be honest. I would not list it for that range. Evan Longoria. Number 72 of 99. I think he's worth more than that. Expressionist Justin Upton. Originals Clayton Kershaw. If the centering was just a little bit better, I'd be trying to buy it from you. Because I love to get stuff like that graded. 34 of 99, Zach Davies, artist proof. Ted Williams, memorable feats. Did Jason act like he wanted it at all? He was in a rough mood anyways today. He had to work. He does not like his work. Trace Thomas, Thompson Mini. Jose Bautista insert. It's a nice looking Cabrera base card. Honus Wagner photo variation. Heritage Collection Greg Maddux. Another Seager rookie, Billy Martin. I think I got the hit card right at the bottom of the stack. Let's see what we get. This is probably going to be an autograph. Behind Socrates here. Best name in baseball. This looks like... Well, that's a different looking card. It's a two-piece jersey, Michael Brantley. What set is that? It's number 85 of 99. I think that's... It says game-used material. I think that's the Diamond King Stars, maybe? Not sure. Nice card, though, for the Brantley spot. Well, congratulations. When's he come back? About a week or two? Nice Brantley card there. Star of the Indians. Oh, well, that's good. Do a little small rehab, as he had not much spring training. Trey Turner is framed. Ricky Henderson, Expressionists. Diamond King Originals, Giancarlo Stanton. Memorable Feats insert of Mel Ott. And that's it. We're three boxes done. Box four. Well, I have AJ Pollock on my team. And he had a similar thing in spring training. I wanted him to get back, and now I wish they would have slowed down with him. Because I'm not sure if he didn't come back too quick or what. That was a bummer injury for somebody that was so good for me last year. I mean, all he did was slide home and just tears up his elbow. Been a lot of injuries, two bad injuries so far this year at least, with Schwarber and Pollock. It's a lot for baseball. Baseball usually doesn't have that big of injuries for hitters. That's more common with pitchers. No, I was close to that. I had 50%. Those are two big players, though, to be wiped off. Especially if you're in a deep league where those are your best players. Box four. Open Museum baseball is pretty nice this year. I got a decent amount of it coming in. I saw they have a Babe Ruth cut auto. That's always fun until it gets pulled. Knowing it's possible. Okay, box four. They don't always put old Babe cut autos in there. It's got a Jackie Robinson cut and a Ty Cobb cut too. But Babe doesn't get in there that often. Ted Williams photo variation is a little more expensive for the companies to buy. Independent insert. All right, we got another one of those framed minis. Last one was Billy. This one is for the Cardinals, Adam Wainwright. For the St. Louis Cardinals, number 73 of 99. One color, one gray color on Wainwright. Framed card of Roberto Clemente, not numbered. Frank Thomas, originals. Shoeless Joe Jackson, memorable feats. Aficionado, Adrian Beltre. Mini of Frankie Crosetti for New York. I don't remember him. Greg Maddux insert. Got a Kirby Puckett photo variation there. And the end of box four, we got an expressionist of Ken Griffey Jr. in his Reds uniform. Something out of 299 here. A good rookie. Dual jersey autograph of Miguel Sano. Nice card there. The Sano owner. Conforto rookie. Jose Bautista parallel, 36 of 99. I saw a couple base for you, but nothing besides that. I did see a couple base cards already. Kirby Puckett originals. But that would be it so far. There's another one right there. Was he St. Louis Browns or St. Louis Cardinals? Looks like he was Cardinals, huh? Hey Philip, how you doing? Honus Wagner insert. Michael Conforto artist proof. Oh, okay, so a little bit of both. That's probably a Cardinals card though. That's a nice number. This is looks like a tougher version of the artist proof. It's number 1 of 25. We got aficionado Felix Hernandez. I got that extra set to you, Philip. I think I just owe you a couple autograph cards right now, if that's what you got down. Jose Bautista, mini. And Will Clark Heritage Collection. And that's box four. Box number five. Oh, well, nice. Well, hopefully I'll hit you a parallel card in the last six, seven, eight boxes. Either way, these cards will be out probably, well, either Tuesday or Wednesday, basically. Well, the cards will go out Tuesday or Wednesday. All right. Box number five. We got an Ozzie Smith Expressionist. Got a Pee Wee Reese mini card. Bryce Harper Originals. Lou Gehrig photo variation. Ted Williams, or no, I'm sorry. Stan Musial memorable feats. And what do we got here? Hit card of George Kelly. Two-piece bat of George Kelly. I think I hit a hit card of him last year, too, in this same product. Number 3 of 25. Nice looking card for somebody out there. Napoljoy framed, not numbered. Aficionado of Dallas Keuchel. Heritage insert Steve Carlton. David Ortiz Expressionists. Bob Musial mini card. Mike Trout Originals insert. Ted Williams photo variation. Shoeless Joe Jackson memorable feats. Nice autograph there for the St. Louis Cardinals, Matt Carpenter. Two-piece jersey auto of Matt Carpenter. Very popular Cardinal, number 87 of 99. We'll finish up box five. Hey, got a parallel of Jim Bottomley. He took off, but he'll appreciate that. 63 of 99. Aficionado Chris Davis. Heritage Collection insert Jose Canseco. Box six. Steve, I would probably list it for like 12, 13, 1400, something like that. I'd probably do 1500 or best offer. I mean, all these things really come down to how quick you want to sell, how tight you want to be, you know. I just think it's worth a little bit. I mean, he's playing well this year. He's gone up in the last month. You got 650 for one number to 50. And that was without fees. I think you should be able to get 1200, 1250 in the end. Maybe even 13. Does the person you sold the orange one have an interest in it? That might be your buyer right there. Or that bought the gold one? Yeah. I mean, if you end up getting 1,000 or 900 later, I mean, after a while, and you have no luck at that price, no big deal, but I think he's gone up a little bit. You might as well try it. Yeah. This one is twice as tough as the one you sold him, though. Adrian Gonzalez, framed card. Andy Pettit, expressionist. Send him a picture and ask him if he's interested. Nolan Ryan, originals. Has he already picked up the gold? Hack Wilson insert. Matt Carpenter mini. Albert Pujols aficionado. Corey Seager photo variation. Oh, okay. Well, maybe you shouldn't contact him then. You don't want to mess up. You don't want to... Dennis Eckersley? Bombard him with too much, maybe. Oh, this could be neat. Nice card there for Stan the Man Musial. A piece of jersey, a piece of bat. Number 24 of 25. For Stan. Oh, you got it already? Well, that's good. Got there quick. Piscotty framed. Ken Griffey Jr. Expressionist. Cal Ripken Jr. Originals. Elston Howard. There was a lot of top loaders in that group. Stephen Piscotty Mini. A lot of Cardinals in this break, huh? Piscotty Auto Jersey, Stan Musial, Matt Carpenter. This was a team break. One team would be just killing it. Adam Wainwright Jersey. Had four Cardinal hits already. D. Gordon Aficionado. Photo variation of Joe DiMaggio. Heritage insert of Lou Brock. And we got a hit card coming up. For the Philadelphia Phillies, two-piece jersey auto, Mikel Franco. Nice card of Franco there. For the Phillies, that wraps up box six. Box seven. Yeah, I can list it. You want me to do 1500 or best offer? I can get it listed tonight. As long as I don't... Unless I open boxes too late, then it'll be early tomorrow, but... I could probably, likely list it tonight. I got to list some Correa autos that I need to list since he's going so well right now. I think he might actually have some more room to go up, though. Philip Kent. It's the wrong team for Philip. Philip is all twins. Got an hit card for the LA Dodgers. I think he is on Cincinnati now, but either way, Jose Peraza. Or is he on the Dodgers now? I'm not sure. 246 of 299. Eric Hosmer framed. Originals of Mariano Rivera. Roger Maris, memorable feats. And number 8 of 25, parallel card of George Springer, artist proof. Aficionado Nelson Cruz. Bob Mutual. Mini, I think we already hit that one once. Jim Palmer insert. Another photo variation of Roberto Clemente. Expressionist Alex Gordon. Ted Williams, memorable feats. Insert. AJ Pollock, aficionado. Pee Wee Reese. Brooklyn Mini, we did get duplicate minis in this box. Andre Dawson, insert. The third Kyle Schwarber photo variation. Expressionist Andrew McCutchen. And we got a framed relic out of 99. For the Pittsburgh Pirates, Jung Ho Gung. For the Pirates, one piece jersey. Numbered 74 of 99. Got a framed card of Brandon Drury for Arizona. And an originals of Buster Posey. Five boxes left. Where's that Ty Cobb relic at? Okay, box seven. Got a relic number 93 of 99 right at the start. Of David Price. One color relic number 93 of 99. Zach Greinke framed, Josh Donaldson insert, memorable feats Gil Hodges, Joey Votto aficionado, mini card of Chris Bryant for the Chicago Cubs. Ooh, that's numbered. Are they all been numbered? No, that's a parallel one. Sweet. Nice card there for Bryant owner. That's number 11 of 25. Did not realize that one was numbered. Let me look through these others. I bet there's a Matt Carpenter. Was that a 25? Just Bryant and Carpenter. Carpenter was number 14 of 25. Ryan Sandberg insert. Joe DiMaggio insert card, or photo variation, I mean. Expressionist Salvador Perez. Excuse me. And we got an auto, I believe, here. Pitcher, Aaron Nola. Seems like Franco and Nola always run together in products. Aaron Nola, number 15 of 99. Aaron's got a nice autograph. Got an Aaron Nola frame there. Originals insert to Jake Arrieta. Bill Dickey memorable feats. Oh, that's number 3 of 25. Diamond King Originals parallel of Pete Rose. Number 3 of 25. Jake Arrieta insert. Mini card of Travis Jankowski. Eddie Murray insert. A photo variation of Michael Conforto and expressionist Yadier Molina. Nice box cards there. Tough Rose and Tough Chris Bryant. Aaron Nola Otto. And the relic was Price. Four boxes left. Need some vintage memorabilia card of some sort. Where's that Ty Cobb relic? Well, it's tougher for me in a player break. You got me down to three players. Well, I'm striking out so far. If you're a Cardinal fan, I guarantee you'd have an auto by now. All right, box number 9, I believe. Four left. Bradley Zimmer's pretty popular, yeah. He's a top 25 prospect in Major League Baseball. I have a Super Fractor up right now on eBay. Clayton Kershaw Mini. Ozzie Smith, Expressionist. There must not be many photo variations, or I'm hitting the same ones over and over. Conforto photo variation. Diamond King Originals, Josh Donaldson. Oh, I got a mini. Number 225. Oh, nice patch. Surprised this ain't framed. Thought they framed all these. Three color patch of Tyler Glasnow. Nice looking card. Number 5 of 25. Nine of 99 framed. So Socrates Brito. I like saying that. Frankie Fritch. Paul Goldschmidt. Steve Carlton insert. Mini of Roger Bresnahan. David Ortiz. Expressionist. Second half of box 9. Numbered 15. I got two parallels here. I think the Lou Gehrig might be a photo variation. And Earl Everill, artist proof, number 15 of 99. Originals, Jake Arrieta. And numbered to 99. Autograph jersey number to 99 for Tampa Bay of Blake Snell. Minor League Player of the Year last year. Two-piece jersey of Blake Snell. Hitting all rookie autos, though. Cannot seem to get. I guess we hit a veteran in Carpenter. Matt Carpenter. Kind of on a rookie tinge after that. Caleb Cowart, parallel. Tony Lazzari, insert. Aficionado Joey Votto. And Frank Robinson insert. Three boxes left. Box number 10. Gotta get something a little bit lower numbered. Something tougher. I guess we've had a few 25. There's another one numbered to 25. Former Philly Mike Schmidt. Parallel insert numbered 14 to 25. Insert of Greg Maddux. Oops. Little mini shoeless Joe Jackson hiding in there. That's numbered out of 25 too. Nice card there. Number 12 of 25. Those minis are hard to spot. They get tucked in. That's our third one, number to 25, Bryant Jackson and Carpenter. Yadi Molina insert, expressionists. Ted Williams, photo variation. Buster Posey originals. Nice relic card. Nomar Mazara. I think Nomar was in the field lot. Nice hit there. He didn't have any base cards or anything. I think he was relic only. Jose Altuve framed. And Joe Jackson. Panini's coalition usually is very similar. I have noticed that over the years. Aficionado Adrian Beltre. And Will Clark insert. Mini card, Corey Kluber. Oh, I didn't even notice that Roger Bresnahan was numbered to 25 also, the mini. So we got four minis numbered to 25. Felix Hernandez insert. Kirby Puckett photo variation. Mariano Rivera insert card. Well, this might be a nice looking card. Oh yeah. Limited lithos. A bat, a jersey, and an auto of Juan Gonzalez. This is the Texas Ranger box. Juan Gonzalez and Nomar Mazara. Henry Owens framed. Memorable feats, Honus Wagner. And aficionado Felix Hernandez. Two boxes left. Box 11. Got a photo variation of Stephen Piscotty. Aficionado insert of Albert Pujols. A nice looking card, or should be a nice looking card. I like this guy. Two-piece auto jersey of Lucas Giolito. Nice card for the Giolito spot. Is that you? On the board. Giolito's popular. Chris Archer framed 77 of 99. Heritage Brooks Robinson insert. Expressionist Ken Griffey Jr., Mariano Rivera, Diamond King Originals. Ted Williams Mini. And Hack Wilson Insert. Lou Gehrig Photo Variation. Aficionado D. Gordon. And two-piece jersey of Matt Kemp for the San Diego Padres. Evan Longoria framed. Dennis Eckersley insert. David Wright expressionists. Number 90 of 99, artist proof, Adrian Gonzalez. Originals, Bo Jackson. Starling Marte Mini. And memorable feats, Elston Howard. Down to one box of cards. One last chance for that Ty Cobb back card. Oh, shoot. I just put the wrong stack in here. These are the ones I want to sleeve. Catch up on my sleeve a little bit here. Okay, one left. I'll do the recap after this. There's a thick card there. Box number 12. aficionado Felix Hernandez. Oops, that mini cards always sneak up on me. Greg Maddux mini card. Not numbered. Insert card, Frank Robinson. Photo variation of Bryce Harper. Expressionist Ricky Henderson. Got a mini card number 14 of 99. Jersey of Edwin Encarnacion. David Ortiz framed. Clayton Kershaw originals insert. Memorable feats, Frankie Fritsch. Oh, nice. Good box for this guy. That says a backwards one of one there. That's the black artist proof one of one of Edwin Encarnacion. Nice card there, the Blue Jay. He might have been in, not sure if he was in the unsold lot I sold or not. Nice card there, though. I know there was one Blue Jay in there that I remember seeing. Aficionado Adrian Beltre. And a mini of Addison Russell. Robin Yount. Heritage insert. And a Kirby Puckett photo variation. Last group. Expressionist Miguel Sano. Here's that super thick card. Could be a good last box with a one of one. The Studio Portraits. Oh, nice player too. Corey Seager for the Dodgers. Check the number second. A good last box of cards for sure. Seager owner's going to like the number 6 of 10. Very limited Seager hit. And I'll finish this last box. If anybody wants a box of cards afterwards, I got a few options that I can open for people. Do the recap first. Salvador Perez was out of 99. Giancarlo Stanton insert. Babe Ruth, memorable feats. I can't do that, Kevin. I will check on that McCann, though, and try to get him for you. Base cards. Let me sleeve up a couple of these and I'll set up the recap. Okay. You bet. Thank you. Thanks for joining the break. Get these organized and I'll go through what I hit. Okay, I think I'm ready. Oh, no, I'm not. A few more cards over here. I thought that variation stack was seemed awfully light. Okay, Diamond King player break on eBay. Let me do the photo variations first. Have a good night, Kevin. We got a lot of duplicates in here. I'll go through them fast, though. These were like two per box. Clemente, Cobb, Trout, Wagner, Williams, Schwarber, Puckett, Gehrig, Piscotty, Puckett, Williams, Gehrig, Schwarber, Clemente, DiMaggio, Corey Seager, Joe DiMaggio, Conforto, Gehrig, Williams, Harper, and Puckett. Got a lot of duplicates in those. Those were two per box. Frames, numbered to 99. We got Caleb Cohart, Bill Ducky, Evan Longoria, and Chris Archer. Oh, a few more. We did get a Jim Bottomley there for the owner. And Brito and Salvador Perez. We're all numbered to 99. We got some parallels numbered to 25. We got a Pete Rose Originals, numbered 3 of 25. A Mike Schmidt Heritage Blue, number 14 of 25. We got some minis numbered to 25. Roger Bresnahan, 10 of 25. Shoeless Joe Jackson, 12 of 25. Matt Carpenter, 14 of 25. And Chris Bryant, number 11 of 25. And other artist proof parallels, we got a Johnny Sane to 99, Adrian Beltre to 99, Zach Davies to 99. We got a Michael Conforto that was number 1 of 25. We got an Adrian Gonzalez to 99, George Springer to 99, and Earl Everill to 99. For the for parallels, we also got an Edwin Encarnacion artist proof. This one was a 1 of 1. Nice card there. Couple mini relics. We got an Edwin Encarnacion jersey, numbered 299, and a Tyler Glasnow patch, three colors there, number 5 of 25. Other minis real quick we got in the break, since they're not too many here. Addison Russell, Maddox, Marte, Williams, Kluber, Kershaw, Janikowski, Pee Wee Reese, Bob Mutual, Biscotti, Bob Mutual, Pee Wee Reese, Jose Bautista, Frankie Grassetti, Trace Thompson, Joe Mauer, Andy Pettit, Lefty O'Doul, Ruzny Castillo, and Mikel Franco. Relic cards. We got a two-piece relic, James McCann, number 8 of 15. We got a George Kelly, two-piece bat, 3 of 25. Stan Musial, jersey bat, number 24 of 25. Adam Wainwright framed, 73 of 99. Billy Martin framed jersey, number 19 of 49. Jung Ho, number 74 of 99. And David Price, 93 of 99. Other relics. We got a Tomas two-piece jersey to 49. Mazzara two-piece jersey to 99. And Matt Kemp two-piece jersey to 25. Autographs. We got Caleb Cowart, number 27 of 99. Stephen Piscotty, number 9 of 99. Michael Brantley, number 85 of 99. We got Miguel Sano out of 299. Matt Carpenter out of 99. Jose Peraza out of 299. Mikel Franco out of 299. Blake Snell out of 99. Aaron Nola out of 99. Excuse me. We got a Juan Gonzalez limited lithos, number 11 of 25. Lucas Giolito, number 173 of 199, and the toughest auto, Corey Seager Studio Portraits, number 6 of 10. Nice card there. And that wraps up the case. We'll probably do another one of these in a couple weeks. I think next week we're going to do Gypsy Queen player break, and we'll be doing Museum this week in the Facebook room.